हेलो।
हेलो,
नमस्ते एवरीवन।
हाय।
आई होप आई एम ऑडिबल। आई एम जस्ट वॉचिंग। प्लीज ब्रीफ मी ब्रेंडा। सो अरु ओके हियर आई सी द प्रीवियस क्लास ऑफ दुर्गेश और दुर्गेश जी योर टीचर। I know her from long time, and her session I just joined for a few minutes before. When she ended the class, I mean the meeting got ended. I mean, but so I think she is the host of our Zoom link. So maybe the meeting could have got ended because I was also in the meeting.
I wondered what happened. I thought it was our Wi-Fi.
No, the meeting was ended from the host and she is in Himalayan yoga. Maybe she is in Rishikesh at the moment at the center. So she is the one who is creating that link. Yep. And today we will see and start with our anatomy and the physiology session. My internet is unstable. There is a message from someone. Okay. I hope I am audible to you all and you can see the whiteboard clearly. That is what I need hear from you. So, yesterday we have just started and discussed with the new students, and also I have seen some of the previous students about the session or about the importance and the introduction of our yoga anatomy and the physiology part. Here again we will just see in short, like yesterday, what we have seen: the anatomy system and the physiology system, where it has been divided into two, the gross and the microscopic type, where the gross anatomy has been divided into the three subtypes. Those are the surface anatomy and the systemic anatomy and the regional anatomy, where the second type of anatomy is the microscopic anatomy, which has the subtypes like cytology, the study of the cell, and apart from it, the histology. Histology is nothing but the study of the tissues. Yes, we have Rohini as well. Yes, namaste. Apart from it, today we have also seen yesterday about some cells, and we have more than billions or two trillions of cells in our body. So the smallest element, the building block of our body, is the cell. The next one about the tissue, just revising it for you all. Can you define a tissue, anybody? What is the tissue in our body and what are its types? The tissue are what? The group of cells. Yes, the group of cells together makes a tissue in our body. And this group of cells which forms the tissue has four major types of tissues. So these four major types of tissues in our whole body are the muscular tissue, the nerve tissue, the epithelial tissue, and the connective tissue. The muscular, the nerve, the epithelial with the connective tissue. So what is this tissue? This tissue is made up of the group of cells in our body. For example, this muscular tissue, if you will see, the cells which makes up our muscle, or the group of cells which makes up our muscle, that is known to be as the muscular tissue. Similarly, we are just revising it in short. The nerve is what? The group of cells which makes up our nerve, the nervous system. Here, all the neurons with the nerve makes up the nerve tissue. The epithelial tissue is what our epidermis, the skin, major part you will see on the surface anatomy here, the region, the epidermis, and the connective tissues you will find in our body in between the joints, which connects our bones together, like tendons and ligaments in our bone joints, which connects our bones and muscles together. These are the major four types of the tissues you will see. Please tell me, just we are revising the previous thing, what we see in the 200 a little bit here. Got it, everyone, up till here? The cells and the tissues, okay? Yep, I can. I hope the internet for everyone is working well.
Yes, sir, perfectly all right. Video and audio is clear.
Okay. For my internet is well, but about the people who are in the center, I hope their internet is also working well, who are in Rishikesh. So, apart from the tissue, one more thing. These were the types of tissues. We will just proceed further about the cells, the tissues, and the next one is the organ. So, the human body, which has been divided into the number of sections, this human body is made up of our three important types, the cells, where the group of cells will make a tissue. And further, what is the organ? These organs in our body are made up of the number of tissues together, or the group of tissues together will create an organ. Approximately, there will be 78 different types or different kinds of organs in our body. Approximately, here the 78 kinds or different types of organs in our body here. All these organs are made up of number of tissues. For example, what is the organ? Organs not only like we find in our abdomen, not only these organs like small intestines, large intestines, the stomach, all the organs which are the parts of the body. Organs are nothing but our parts, the structure of the body. Like we have our glands in our body, we have the pineal gland, the thyroid gland, we have the region of the throat, we have our heart, our brain, our cerebrum of the brain, the cerebellum of the brain, the small brain, medulla oblongata. So these all the kinds of organs together will make number of 78 organs, like kidneys or pancreas in our stomach, the spleen. There are many, many more organs here in our whole body that is made up of number of tissues. And those tissues are nothing but which are made up of number of cells. And in our whole body, how many number of cells will be there? More than 100 billion or 100 trillion, sorry, 100 trillion cells will be there in our whole body. Yes, anyone? Oh, great. Yeah. Up till here, we have just seen like the cells, tissues, and organs. So apart from this, the human body, which we have seen, this is made up of the cells, tissues, and organs. Now we will proceed further and see some anatomical systems. And from that anatomical system, before, we will see some anatomical terminology of our body. So up till here, if it is clear, we will proceed further with the anatomical terminology. So what is this anatomical terminology of human body? So anatomical terminology. or just writing the word terminology? Of anatomy, because we are learning anatomy, so anatomy terminology. I'm just writing in short so that you can see the whiteboard. From this anatomical terminology, first term, we have to know the directional planes. Again, we have to study the directional planes, or we have to know about the direction. We have to know about the direction. So what are the directional planes or the directions here? That directional planes of our body, which will help us to identify or to locate the names of our bones and the names of our muscles or the names of our organs in our whole body. So we need to understand some directional terms. What are these directional terms? The first one, directional term. For example, in this directional term, the first one here, I will write superior term. I will use this blue marker. I hope you can read, because I cannot type on my mobile because it is kept horizontal. Yeah, or I could have typed like this quickly. So here, the superior, the first term. What is this superior and inferior, the second term? These are the directional terms, all we are watching now. So, yes, Brittany, yes, Blake, Ovinichi, anyone, Brenda, the superior, you studied Blake in your course before.
Superior would mean, like going up, and inferior would mean like going down. So superior would be your head, inferior would be like your feet, towards your feet, or towards your head, superior.
Yeah, if Amber, I think it's Amber only. Yep, great. Yep. Good. The superior terms is what? The part of the body or the structure of our body which is towards the upper part or towards the head. So whatever parts or the structure, whatever bones, muscles, organs are being there towards the upper region, towards our head, those are categorized into our superior term. Again, inferior means those muscles or those bones, some muscles are named up from these inferior and superior terms, or those parts of the body which lie towards the feet or towards the bottom region of our body, like the muscles in our calves or in our thighs or in our feet or the bones. So those bones or those muscles are in the region, inferior region. In the superior region, our head, forehead, face is all on the superior. Inferior, our thighs, calf are in our inferior. Similarly, we have, apart from the superior and inferior, the ventral and dorsal region, or ventral and dorsal, or you can also write posterior and anterior. We'll make it more simple. They are the same. Dorsal or ventral, or posterior or anterior. So those, like here, if you can see, Amber raised her hand. Yes, Amber, I will allow you.
Thank you. To clarify, dorsal is another word for anterior and ventral is another word for posterior?
Yes. So okay, they are the cavities of our body. Those are the cavities of our body. That we will see later. So first, anterior, whatever the parts and the structure of our body, which lies in the front, whatever muscles, bones, parts are the body, which lies in the front, those three parts, muscles, bones are known to be as the anterior region. What are, for example, if I will ask you, where is the kneecap? Where is the kneecap in our body? Towards the anterior region, not how is the kneecap, but towards the anterior side of our leg. So where are the quadriceps muscles? These legs, we know what are the quads. So those muscles are at the anterior region of our thigh, on the top of the thigh here. And the posterior means back of the leg. Anterior means in the front of the leg. These are just the anatomical difficult words. You can say in front and back. That's it. Just to clear the concept, okay? Apart from this anterior and posterior parts, so like, for example, what is the posterior? Where is your shoulder blade? Yes, where is the shoulder blade located? At the posterior region, at the back. So this is what the parts where we can, or which can be easily named, or which can be easily located on behalf of these terms. For example, again, the medial and lateral. I hope you see. Similarly, medial and the lateral, these two terms will be those parts or the regions who are in the center, which lies at the midline of the body, and the lateral parts are which lies from away from the midline of the body. So for example, your middle fingers or your heart is at the medial side, and the lateral side is what? Your pinky finger, which is at the lateral side of your palm. For example, your pinky toe as well as the lateral side of your feet. So the lateral sides, whatever the regions, whatever the muscles, whatever the bones will be there at the lateral side. Lateralis muscles, the lats, which are at the back. That is the lateral, and the medial region are in the center. Apart from this, now we have again the proximal and distal. Again, one more two. Proximal and distal. So what about the proximal and the distal? These two terms. These two terms are nothing but the starting or the ending. Near, proximal means, or proximal or distal, these terms means like mostly used in our upper limbs and lower limbs. For example, like the distal bone of our upper arm, or the ankle. Where is the ankle? Ankle is at a distal end from our knee, which is away from the knee. And proximal is what? Which is near. So if I will say the femur or the bone in our thigh, that is what? The starting end of our bone in our thigh, that is at the proximal end from our hip. This is what, like the wrist. Where is our wrist? This is located away from our elbow. So distal end from our elbow. Where is our bicep? So these parts, these muscles, the proximal is what, where the upper limb starts or the lower limb starts. The starting point is proximal point and the ending point is what, the distal. So of, if I will consider this hand, this is shoulder is my proximal point and the fingers is, or the wrist are my distal point. Okay. So this is what? The directional terms which are very, very important to know. Please note it down, or if you have noted it down, everyone, let me know. I will erase this as well. Is it clear, this thing? Rue, Amber, Brenda, and?
Yes, it's clear.
Yes, Jennifer. Thank you.
Yes, yes, okay. It's clear. It's clear, thank you.
Okay, now you can mute yourself and thank you. I will erase it. Greg, are you raising your hand?
Hi, yes, sorry. I was just wanting to ask about, is it cranial and caudal? Is that how you say it? Is that also terms that we would use in yoga anatomy?
Cranial. Caudal, yes. Yeah. This cranial means superior end, caudal, inferior end. Yes, the same terms which I have used in the previous time. Yep. This is just more simple term. Can I erase now? Okay. Now, we have to see the planes of our body. Planes of our body. What are these planes of our body? More simple. We have three planes. The frontal plane, the lateral plane, and the transverse plane. In the anatomical terminology only, first we have seen the directional terms. In that we have seen 8 directional terms. Now the next here are the planes of our body. And here write down the 3 planes, the frontal, lateral, and the transverse plane. Again, so frontal plane is what? When we can see our human body from the front. So this is what? The human body where we can see from the front and the back. This is the front plane. Like you can see, this is what? The front plane, back and front. Similarly, the lateral plane, when our structure of our body or the part of our body is being seen laterally, means from side. This is the side view, the lateral plane, this axis is what, the side view of mine. So there will be a right side and the left side. So right and the left side will be the lateral plane. I can just show you because we are online. I have to turn and do many more things here. In future, I have to do more asanas behind the camera over the stage for some yoga therapy as well. Again, transverse plane is what? That plane of the body where we can see from the top and the bottom. So when a human body or the structure of the bone or the muscle is being seen from the top view or from the bottom view, that particular plane of the body is known to be as the transverse plane. For example, if we cut the human body from the center and if we see the top and the bottom view, that is what? Nothing but our transverse plane. These important three planes and the directional terms are very important to locate and name the muscles and identify their functions in our life. This is what the more important. Again, for the blade, the terms which we have used for the frontal plane and the lateral or the transverse plane were different. Those were the coronal plane, sagittal plane, and medial plane. Got it? So you can also write it as coronal plane. This term I have not used before, or you could have got confused, but it is nothing but frontal plane only. This lateral plane is known as sagittal plane. And median plane and the first we clear the concept, the front, left, side to side, front, and then transfer from top to bottom. When we cut the section from the midline. Okay. Written down. I hope you can see this one. Yep. Thank you. The Blaze and Brittany are sitting next to each other, I think. Yeah, I can see. And why using two cameras? Why not one camera? So I can see other students on my screen as well. Like we have Amber and Brenda. No problem. Enjoy. So I will erase this, okay? Just say yes or no. So in this anatomical terminology, again, apart from this, what we have seen, the directional term, and what else we have seen, the planes of the body, we will also see, Dagmar, namaste, we will also see here, the cavities of our body, or the third point in the body cavities. So the cavities of our body. In how many cavities our body is been divided? It is been divided into two major cavities. That is ventral cavity and dorsal cavity. The ventral cavity and the dorsal cavity. We already know, or we have seen, what is the ventral and the what is the dorsal cavity. So ventral cavity is the cavity which lies in the front region. That is the anterior and the posterior cavity. Anterior means ventral and dorsal means the posterior at the back. So the cavity which lies in the front, that is ventral. In this ventral cavity and in this dorsal cavity, we have two bone types under the ventral cavity. One is the cranial cavity and also the thoracic cavity. Abdominopelvic. Here, in our cranial cavity and in the abdominopelvic cavity. So what is this cranial cavity of our body? And what is the abdominopelvic cavity? Cavity is what? Where our part or the structure of our body are residing. So in our cranium region, in our head section, in our cranium, this is what? The ventral part, we will see all the parts. Apart from this cranium, there is abdominopelvic cavity as well. Just make sure write the thoracic one. Thoracic cavity and the abdominopelvic.
So what happened and to the cranial?
Cranial at the dorsal. We have the skull at the back. The thoracic region, the torso region is at the front, the anterior region. The cranial region, the skull is at our back, posterior part, not at the anterior side. And the at the dorsal region, we find this region, the thoracic. I mean the cranial region at the back. At the dorsal end. And about the abdomen and the pelvic here, abdominopelvic bones are at the in front, where our stomach, all the organs, where our lungs are in our whole torso and in front cavity of our body, where in our dorsal cavity, we have our cranial cavity as well, here residing, and spine. That's it. Nothing else, like central nervous system. Similarly, like central nervous system, sympathetic and parasympathetic nerves. The cranial, the central nervous system is made up of our brain and the spine. That's it. The cranial and the spine is at the dorsal end, where at the ventral end, our thoracic region at the front with our torso and abdomen. All the parts in our body are like heart, lungs, intestines, stomach, and spleen, pancreas, liver will lie all in the front in our thoracic region or the torso region. This is just to know in how many sections the body is being divided, the cavities of the body are being divided. So in this anatomical terminology, we will see the directional.
Sir, yeah, we can't say we have any three cavities, the cranial, the thoracic, and the abdominopelvic region. We have to describe the ventral cavity and the dorsal cavity. Actually, I think so. If we divide the four cavities simple, the cranial, the abdominal, dorsal and ventral, it's a little bit of confusion for me, actually.
So this is the anterior part. So what I have said, the first, I will just write in bracket about the ventral, that is anterior part. And what this anterior plane or anterior direction means, which are in the front region, at the front surface, part of our body, anterior and posterior, I will write under the dorsal, posterior. Before what we have written down, the directional terms like anterior and posterior, like superior and inferior, in that I erased these terms, ventral and dorsal, so we could get confused. But now, here in bracket, I have again written ventral cavity means anterior region of our body at the front, and the dorsal cavity is what? Our posterior region, all the vertebrae and all the spine and the cranial region behind in our body. That's it. This is just our system. Even deleting these body cavities, in simple terms, our body has just five sections: head, neck, trunk. This is whole trunk, that is torso, abdomen, upper back, and lower back. So torso, abdomen, upper back, and lower back will make whole trunk. And then the next two are our upper limbs and lower limbs. So this whole trunk in front of torso and abdomen will lie in our ventral cavity, and in the dorsal cavity, we have the upper and the lower back region. That's up to here. Very easy. Where we? Now, I hope you got the about the anatomical terminology in short. We will proceed further and see what are the bodily systems. these terms and these names, you will be able to know as we will proceed further with the bodily systems. Today we will start. We have just few minutes left, but we will directly start as we have just studied about the terms of the anatomy. We have to start and we will learn about skeletal system. We will just give a start and a short intro of it, and we will see about the skeletal system in deep and in depth from tomorrow. What is the skeletal system? Just give a heading in your notebook for today. Yes, I will ask here Blaze, who was there, or Amber. The skeletal system is made up of the bone system. Okay. Yes. Do you know, or do we know, how many number of bones will be there in our body?
Anyone? I'd say 1 million, but I'm going to say 206 instead. Okay.
Yes.
206?
Yes, with Amber. First, I will tell everyone. Amber is the student from the previous group, and she is a funny student. And her favorite word is 1 million. Okay. Even she knows the answer. So, correct, Amber, 206 is what the number of bones in our body. And we will have to study all these 206 number of bones. Slowly, slowly, we will have to see about, after we study all these bones, we will study about the structure of the bone. We will also study some therapy or the tissues of the bones. So these two number of six bones are being divided into two types. Those are axial skeletal system and appendicular skeletal system. Just write down the two types of the skeletal system. First one axial and second one appendicular. This axial skeletal system, the first type, is what? Where we find all the bones of our body in one axis. That means in our head, in our face, in our neck, in our trunk, or in our torso, or in our back, or in our one axis. That is axial skeletal. And appendicular skeletal system means the bones we will find in our arms and legs. Very simple. You can define this. Axial in one axis, the bones, and appendicular in arms and legs. Write down this. Can you see this whiteboard here? Yeah. Do you understand these two? Axial, what is the axial? The bone, Brittany, which are?
So I got that the appendicular is the arms and legs, but what is the axial? Can you repeat?
Axial means the bones which lie in our one axis of the body. The arms and legs are not in the axis. They are more. So in what is in one axis? Like the bones in our chest, like ribs, the bones in our neck, the bones in our face, or the bones in our head in one axis. It's axial skeleton.
I see.
Okay. That in depth we will see again from tomorrow, not today. Up in here, whatever questions you have for today, you can please ask or anything.
Can I just ask what we've discussed all in today's lesson? Because we missed a big chunk in the beginning because our Wi-Fi dropped out. Even if you can just tell us the heading, that way we can go and research it. I think you were talking about the cells.
Yes, your voice is too low. I have to Okay. We are talking about the cells. Then we have seen some things about the tissues, the types of tissues. We revise what we have already learned in 200 hours. So we have to revise that types of tissues. That's short revision. And apart from that, we have also revised what are the organs. Again, about after the organs, these cells, tissues, and organs will make up our human body. And then we have seen the anatomical terminology of our human body. And in that anatomical terminology, we have seen the directional terms, which will be helpful to identify and locate the structure and the bones and the muscles. Apart from it, we have seen the planes of our body, the three frontal, transverse, and the lateral plane, and then the cavities of our body. That's it, we have seen. And just we started about the skeletal system, where Amber answered 1 million of bones in our whole body. And she also gave the correct answer to 06 with two different types of skeletal system, axial and appendicular, that we will learn in depth from tomorrow.
Okay, thank you. I think that's everything.
That's a lot of things. Thank you so much. And try to carry your notes and a paper or a pen from tomorrow. We have to locate all these bones and study it in depth. Namaste, everyone. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. See you tomorrow.
Yeah.